revamped lineup of curricular choirs, including a men's choir, as well as performances from all four a cappella groups.
We'd like to thank you all for coming out tonight, and we'd also like to thank you with all of your help with our fall mum sale. We raised over $11,000 that will help to support our touring singers on their trip to the East Coast in the spring, along with the many other exciting new activities and projects.
Please give yourselves a round of applause. Yes. We would clap for you ourselves, but two people clapping is kind of lengthy, so. We hope you enjoy the show.
Thank you. so much for joining us for this evening's concert. We really appreciate your attendance and your support of all of the students that are in the choral program at Barrington High School. My name is Brandon Pemberton, and I am the director of choirs here at the school. And Katie Kenya, you saw with our first group, the Grace Notes. She is our associate director of choirs here. So can we have a round of applause for her? There she is. She really is a fantastic teammate, and I'm so lucky to have her, so thank you for your work. So we want to just talk a little bit, as we go through the concert this evening, about the groups that you're hearing, the restructuring that we did of some of the ensembles this year, so that you have an understanding of maybe why we did that and how it makes sense musically for the kids. So you've heard two ensembles so far this evening. The first group was the Grace Notes. Those were all freshmen women. And I think for 14, 15-year-old young ladies, they did a really, really nice job. So can we have one more round of applause? You heard 10, which is our all-male a cappella group. And we have four student-led a cappella groups here. And it's been a real joy this year to watch these guys rehearse because they take such pride in what they do, and it really helps them develop wonderful leadership opportunities and skills through their participation in those roles. So you'll hear three more of those ensembles that we can talk a little bit more later this evening about. The second ensemble that you heard was Intermezzo. This is one of the groups that was part of the restructuring. Intermezzo is an intermediate women's ensemble that you just heard. About 50 young ladies that sing in that ensemble, and I'm really excited about the work that they're doing, because the last piece that they just sang for you, I Will Be Earth by Gwyneth Walker, it's a wonderful piece that was chosen to be one of the All-State pieces for Illinois All-State Choir this year, and I'm very proud, and I'm going to say that over and over and over again tonight, I'm very proud that we have an intermediate level treble ensemble that is performing All-State level repertoire in this first concert. So, thank you. And I want to talk a little bit about what's coming up. There's a lot going on in the choral world at this school at this moment. So obviously tonight's concert, and then Thursday are the All-State Choir auditions, and we have a number of students that are auditioning for that. Those auditions will take place at Crystal Lake South High School, and these students have to prepare 5 pieces. And the judges, well, not the judges, the district representative that manages our region of the state chooses a selection from 2 of those songs that they have to sing for a judge, and they're scored and evaluated based on their preparedness in that way. They also have to sing scales, they have to sing triads, and they have to do sight reading. And then they take the top scoring singers from the state of Illinois and they put them in an All-State choir. Actually, there are 2. There's an honors All-State choir and a regular All-State choir. And it's a real honor to be selected for that. We live in a state where this is very competitive. Many students, I would say over 1,000 soprano ones, audition in our region alone, and they're at 9. So it's a very competitive process, and the kids that are preparing for that are well prepared, and they're doing a really nice job. So we look forward to that on Thursday. Next week, we have our Spotlight production, and the Spotlight production is designed specifically for freshman students to have a showcase. So we have students that are acting, dancing, singing, we have visual artists that will be represented. The show takes place in the Black Box Theater, and it's going to be next Thursday and Friday at 7 p.m., and tickets are available for that, so we hope that you will join us for those. Those kids have done a great job. And lastly, our madrigal season is underway, and we have, I think, 56 or so madrigal singers this year. I was really proud of the turnout for the auditions. We heard about 80 students audition for madrigal groups. I think that's pretty impressive. When you have a Renaissance choral ensemble in high school, and you have 80 kids audition for it, I think that's really a wonderful thing, and we have a long history of having madrigal groups here that are respected and sought out by members of the community. So. You can look for more information about that. We'll talk a little bit more about that later as well, but we have a couple of big events, big performances that we hope that you will join us for as well. So the next group that you're going to hear is an all-female a cappella group called Premium Blend. So if you would welcome them to the stage, they would greatly appreciate that. Thank you.
Today we'll be singing Grenade by Bruno Mars with soloist Holly Snyder and Ellie Pulido.
We hope you enjoy.
If you want to
Up here to hear every part as well as we should be able to. So So hopefully that you're hearing a big difference in that way tonight with each of these acapella groups. I want to talk a little bit about Choral Leaders, our all-men's group that we started this year that you heard. We have 28 guys that are performing in that ensemble this semester, which I'm really excited about. My goal was 20, so I think that we're in really good shape for starting a new ensemble. We took a trip to Milwaukee a couple of weeks ago, and we did a men's choral festival that I got an email about and thought it was really exciting to be able to take the guys up there, and we sang in a festival format with over 1,000 other high school boys. And it was a really positive experience for us to be able to get together and see that singing is possible for young men, and it is fun, and it is cool, and it is acceptable. And they got to see a professional adult male barbershop group perform. And they also got to hear the men's choir from the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee perform as well. So I think that was really positive, and I hope you enjoyed hearing them sing. The first piece that they sang for you, Come Travel With Me, is actually the All-State men's piece for this year. So again, we have an intermediate level group doing All-State level repertoire, so we're really excited about that. I want to tell you a little bit more about the next group you're going to hear. This is Bella Voce. This is our advanced treble ensemble. They are singing some collegiate level repertoire that I want to tell you about, because I think you will hear the piece differently if you know a little bit about it before you hear it. So, let's see if I can multitask and flip my page. This piece is called On the Strangest Sea. It's the third song you're going to hear them sing, and I want to just tell you a little bit about the text. This is an Emily Dickinson poem. Hope is the thing with feathers. And I love this poem. I think it's fabulous, and I think the composer did a really beautiful job of illustrating the text with the music. So I want to draw your attention to that. The text is, hope is the thing with feathers that perches in the soul and sings the tune without the words and never stops at all. And sweetest in the gale is heard, and sore must be the storm that could abash the little bird that kept so many warm. I've heard it in the chillest land and on the strangest sea, yet never in extremity it asked a crumb of me. It's a beautiful poem. So here's what the composer wrote a little bit in some of his notes here. He says, the violin part that you'll hear, it's played by one of our chamber choir students, Heather Hess. The violin represents the bird in the poem. So listen for that. See if you can hear some musical mini motifs from the violin part that might represent that. He says, the bird represents hope as it passes through many different climates, some of them very unpleasant. So you'll hear them move through a variety of landscapes throughout the piece. So hopefully that gives you a little bit of a sense of what to expect when you hear that third song. The first two are completely in English, and you should be able to follow along pretty well with those. But I wanted to give you a little bit of information, some background on that third piece. Enjoy Bella Voce. Thank you. Isn't that a great piece?
It's solid. It's such an interesting piece.
Not easy. So much mixed meter singing in that piece. Not only do they split into eight parts and sing in very close dissonant harmonies, but they're moving between mixed meters, so they're counting seven beats, five beats. This one has six. This one has eight. This one has three. This one has four. Now we're back to seven. And it changes throughout. And he said it because he chose a Latin text and a melody from a Gregorian chant, which at that time there would not have been a set meter, like we have four beats per measure as we do now. So he set it in a mixed meter that way to give that effect, because it was more about making the text fit and not about fitting a text to a meter. So that was a really nice challenge for them, and they did a really great job. So that's Bella Voce. You're going to hear another a cappella group next, which is E Harmonies, and they're singing and dancing. This group has done a really nice job. This is another arrangement that I think is especially difficult, that they've worked very hard on, and I know they're proud to share this with you. So let's have a warm welcome to E Harmonies.
Da da da.
appreciate you listening to me talk all night. This next group is our chamber choir. I want to tell you a little bit about them. I'm really excited about this group. We have 41 members. It's a mixed choir. It's our advanced mixed ensemble. And they have three songs that they're going to sing for you. These are all songs by living composers or arrangers. The first is called October Sun, and this is a pretty new piece. And it's a really beautiful way to paint the landscape of an October kind of scene. So you'll enjoy that. The second piece that they're singing is called The Ground by a composer named Ole Yalo. He's doing a lot of work right now. This is one of the all-state pieces for this year. And then we're closing with an arrangement of the spiritual Ezekiel. This is also an all-state piece for this year. And I'm very proud that they're able to actually perform it in our own concert. It's an advanced collegiate level piece. It's very difficult for many reasons. First, because it's a cappella, so they have no support from the piano at all. It's an eight-part harmony the entire time. It's about 5 minutes long, and it's in a two-choir format. So really, they are split into two independent ensembles that perform together during this piece. It's really, really well done, and we're excited to be able to share that with you. So without further ado, this is the chamber choir. I want to take a moment to say one final thank you. Thank you again so much from Katie and I and all of the kids for your continued support of the work that we do here in the Choral Department. I think these kids are really awesome and they're really special to us, and we're really proud of the work that they've done in just the first 5 or 6 weeks of school. So I'm really excited to see what the rest of the year holds, if this is our starting point. So we're very excited about that. We've got one more piece that we want to share with you, which is a tradition in the fall concert, an Irish blessing. But before we do that, with your continued support, I know that many of you are already members of the Fine Arts Booster Club. There will be a Booster Club representative and table out in the lobby after the concert, so stop by, say hi, that's something that you might want to get involved with. This is our last piece, an Irish blessing. Thank you.